is video number 50 for bass players, and in this video we are going to be learning half notes. All right, so I need you to open up to page number 22 in your Essential Elements book, and then look over here on this board. Now, what I have drawn on the board are the notes that we have already learned. We started off with quarter notes, and there were four quarter notes in a measure of 4/4 time. Then we took that quarter note and we chopped it in half and created 2/8 notes. And then that became 8/8 notes in one measure of 4/4 time, okay? This got one beat, each of these got half a beat. Now, rather than chopping the quarter note in half, we're gonna kind of do the opposite. We're gonna combine two quarter notes together. So each quarter note gets one beat. So if we combine two quarter notes together, what we get is something called a half note. A half note looks much like a quarter note, except it's not colored in. And just like quarter notes, the stem on a half note can go down like that as well, okay? Just depends on where the note is on the staff. So if these two quarter notes make one half note, then these last two quarter notes make another half note. And now the measure is full, because guess what? A half note takes up half a measure. That's only true in 4/4 time, okay? So look at this for a second. A half note gets two quarter notes. How many eighth notes would be in one half note? There would be 1, 2, 3, 4 eighth notes in one half note. Now, when we were bowing and we did a full bow for a quarter note, and of course, remember, when I say a full bow for bass, what I really mean is just from down at the frog until about here, okay? We're calling that the full bow, right about where that tape is. And then on the eighth note, we used half of that, right? Well, for a half note, we're actually going to use the same amount of bow that we do on a quarter note. We're just going to move our bow twice as slow. All right, so watch me do quarter notes. Here's quarter notes. 1, 2, 3, 4. Slow bow for half notes. I'm gonna go back to quarter notes. Turn the metronome on. And on the metronome, I have eighth notes clicking, and that's for a reason. I'll show you why later on. It's to make us be more accurate. So here's quarter notes. They're gonna get two clicks, because these are eighth notes clicking. 1, 2, 3, 4, slow bow, slow bow. 1, 2, 3, 4, slow bow, slow bow. Quarter notes get full bow, so do half notes, just go twice as slow. All right, now I want you to look at number 77 in your book. And we are going to do something different that we've not done yet. When you see the half notes, we're going to bow in the air, okay? When you see the half notes, make sure you go twice as slow. And the reason we're doing this is because you'll be able to tell if you're actually going twice as slow on the half notes. If you end up having to do this to do your half notes, you're not going twice as slow, and you're going to have a problem when we get to the instrument. So let's do 77, bowing in the air, just up and down, straight up and like this, okay? 1, 2, with the repeat, 77, and go. 1, 2, 3, 4, slow bow, slow bow. Measure 3, 1, 2, 3, 4, slow bow, rest, lift, repeat. 1, 2, 3, 4, slow bow, slow bow. 1, 2, 3, 4, one tay, two tay, off. Now the reason I want the eighth notes clicking, it is a very common problem for people to, on the last note of a song, either play it too long or too short. Now, if we will count with eight, using the eighth notes, we're less likely to mess that up. We need to make sure it gets how many clicks for a half note? 4. So it's going to get 3, 4, off. You're off on beat 3. I'm sorry, it's in this case, it's 1, 2, off on beat 3, because the half note happens at the beginning of the measure. Let's try now bowing number 77 on open D. Okay, let's play number 77 on open D. And get your good bow hold. 1, 2, 3, 4. Go. 1, tay, 2, tay, 3, tay, 4. Slow bow, slow bow. 1, tay, 2, tay, 3, tay, 4, tay. Slow bow, rest, lift, repeat. 1, 2, 3, 4. Slow bow, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, tay, 2, tay, rest. All right, I move the camera back just a tiny bit more so you can actually see how I'm bowing. All right, go on to 78. And I want you to shadow bow first. Remember, when you shadow bow, you're gonna put your bow right here and you're gonna bow here, all right? But you're still gonna do all the fingers. Your fingers should be moving as the notes change, all right? Shadow bow as I play, you're here, and you're shadow bowing along with me as I play. 1, 2, shadow bow, 78, go. D, 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 now E. Slow bow, slow. Bow. 1, tay, 2, tay, rest and lift, repeat. 1, tay, 2, tay, 3, tay, 4, tay. 1, tay, 2, tay, off. Okay? Now play that with me. Now if you think you need shadow board again, that's fine. Practice it. Maybe practice at a slower tempo. Measure 3 is the one that's a little tricky. Okay, 78, play with me now. Good bow holds. 1, 2, 78, and go. D, 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 E. Now slow bow for an F sharp, the E. Let's go again. 1, tay, 2, tay, rest and lift, repeat. 1, tay, 2, tay, rest. Okay? Now, before you try to do the next video, I need you to be really good at number 78. Because what we're going to do in the next video is we're going to take number 78 and we're going to go faster and faster and faster and faster and faster and faster and faster until we're playing it twice as fast. So we're playing it like at 66 right now. I want to be playing it at like 130, 132-ish. Okay? So practice it at the speed. Get really good at it. And then you'll be ready for video 51.